Hello Spartans, welcome to the family of Spartans GRE. I am Krishna. I take pride to be a part of your journey towards your destination and to give you the best I can. Despite my busy schedule, I chose to leverage four powerful resources: Facebook, YouTube, WhatsApp and Telegram to get this job done. All the links of the above mentioned resources are given in the description of this video. I wish you imbibe all the qualities of a Spartan, such as discipline, perseverance and focus, to reach your goal. Now the time is ripe to hitch wagon to a star. So let's get started. Once again, I welcome you to the family and happy learning. In this video, we will discuss Challenger Series questions from August 31st. So this is we have 5 questions on August 31st. Let's go with our first question. Here goes the story. This says average age of a couple was 24 years. That means let the two persons, couple be A and B, their average is 24 years. That means each of them has 24 years. So total age will be 24 into 2, which is 48 years. So 48 years combinedly they have. So after first and second children, twins were born, the average age of the family becomes 13.5. So let the twins be C and D. Now the average age is 13.5. That means then total age will be, we have 4 people here, total age will be 54 years. So total age will be 54 years. Now if you observe the change, there is an increase of 6 years. So that means there is an increase of 6 years from here to here. Anyway, if you see at this instance, the age of these two people is 0, right? Because when they are born, their age will be 0. But then there is an increase of 6 years. That 6 years is increased because these two people age has been increased from here to here. That means since there is an increase of 6 years for both persons, there will be an increase of 3 years for one person. That means the age gap, the here time gap is 3 years. Which means after 3 years from this point, their twins were born. So this time gap is 3 years. This we put it aside. Now again we have A, B and C, D. Now he is saying one more person is born, the third child. Here is the third child. When he is born, the average age was 13.2 years. That means 13.2 into how many people are there? 5 people are there now. So total age will be 66 years. Now the age gap is, here it will be 12 years. Right? 12 years. Why there is an increase of 12 years? Now you see, here his age will be 0 anyway at this point, at this instance, his age is 0. But then, the age of these 4 people is increased by 12 years. So here the gap is 3 years. Why? Because 12 by 4 is 3 years. So there is, after 3 years from second this point, E is born. Now again we continue with the story. A, B, C, D, E and one more person is born. The fourth child is born, let him be F. The average of the family is 16 years. So now we have 6 people and age is 96 years total. And the age gap we are getting here 30 years. This 30 years is increased because this anyway is 0 at this point of time. Now A, B, C, D, E, this age from here to here, from here to here, there is an increase of 30 years. That means 30 is divided among 5 people. That means 6 years. So the age gap, time gap from here to here is 6 years. Now the question says the current age of the family is 19 years. Now the age of the family is 19 years and there are total 6 people. The same 6 people. Here no one is born newly. So it will be 114 years. Right? So what is the age gap here? 114 minus 96, it will be 18 years. So here we are getting 18 years. This 18 years is because all these 6 people, so 3 years. Now here the time gap is 3 years. So the question is, what is the current age of the twins? Twins are born here. So from here to here, age gap is 3 years. From here to here, it is 6 years. From here to here, it is 3 years. That means total, it will be 3 plus 6 plus 3, which is 12 years. So age of the twins now, currently at this instance, is 12 years. So answer for this is 12 years. Let's move to our second question. If the mileage of a car is 15 kilometers for 1 liter, so 1 liter a car can travel 15 kilometers, and in 2 hours 1 liter of petrol is leaked. Now he says, find the minimum speed, underline this word, it is minimum speed, to cover 60 kilometers in 7 liters of fuel. Since he is asking minimum speed, that means if speed is minimum, then time will be maximum. So he has to take more time to travel. Okay, so speed should be minimum. So to take more time, here he has 7 liters of fuel, right? But actually, to cover 60 kilometers, how many liters of fuel he need? He needs to travel 15 kilometers, he need 1 liter. So to travel 60 kilometers, he needs 4 liters, but still he has 3 liters extra with him. 3 liters extra with him. If he wastes these 3 liters, that means he is taking more time. So 1 liter leakage, it takes 2 hours to leak 3 liters. These extra 3 liters can be leaked, right? So to get these 3 liters leaked, he takes 6 hours. So total he is taking 6 hours to travel. So speed will be distance by time, 10 kilometers per hour. So since he is asking the minimum speed, he has to take maximum time. That means he has to waste more time. Let's solve our question number 3. This question, we need to find the remainder. Whenever you are asked to find the remainder, first check the divisor, whether it is a prime number or a co-prime number. Here 21 is not a prime number. 21 can be written as 7 into 3, which means this is a co-prime number, it's not a prime number. Prime numbers are 7 and 3. So according to Chinese remainder theorem, we have to apply Chinese remainder theorem here because the divisor is not a prime number. When the divisor is a co-prime, then we have to go by Chinese remainder theorem. And when the divisor is a prime number, then we go by Euler's theorem. So we apply two theorems here, and I request you to comment in this video, comment below whether you need a clear cut video on both these topics. If you are really interested, only then I can make a clear cut video on these two topics. Okay, so please do comment. For now, I will just explain as much as needed for this question. Okay. Let's start. So 25 power 20 by 7. So we have to find the remainders individually for 7 and 3. For this, we will get the remainder as 7 is 7, 3 is a 21. So we will get a remainder of 4 here. 4 power 20, because we have 24s. This is one remainder. Similarly, for 26 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 5 power 20 by 7, or you can also write, better include a negative remainder. You can say minus 2 whole power 20 by 7. This is the negative remainder here. Next, 27 power 20 by 7, remainder will be minus 1 whole power 20 by 7, which means if we get the 28, remainder will be 0, but then we have 27, which means there is a deficit of 1. That means the remainder is minus 1. Similarly, 28 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 0. For 29 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 1 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 1. Similarly, for 30 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 2 power 20 by 7. Similarly, 31 power 20 by 7, remainder will be 3 power 20 by 7. Till here, everything is fine. So here now we will have to apply Euler's theorem. Actually, believe me, if you know Chinese remainder theorem and Euler's theorem, this question you can solve in less than a minute. All these things I am doing here very clearly so that you will understand, but not that it is difficult, okay? So 4 power 20 by 7, if you apply Euler's theorem, what does Euler's theorem say? Suppose if there is a number x, by it is divided by n, then x by n, x power Euler's number of n, or multiple of Euler's power Euler of n, will always give you remainder 1. So what is the Euler's number of n here? If n is a prime number, Euler's number will always be 1 less than the given number. So Euler's number of 7 will be 6. So accordingly, it should be written as 4 power 20 can be written as 4 power 3 whole power 6 into 4 square by 7. According to Euler's theorem, this is the Euler's number of this. So any number written, that means any number means x. X written in the form of Euler's number will, when divided by that given number, it will be 1. So finally you are left with 4 power 2, that is 16 by 7. Now remainder will be 2. So 4 power 20, this you got the remainder as 2. Write it here. For this one, you have to apply it again. Minus 2 power 20, anyway you will get a positive remainder, because minus negative to the power even will give you even. So minus 20 to power 20 can be written as 20 power 20 by 7. This can be written as 2 power 3 whole power 6 into 2 square by 7. This remainder will be 1 anyway. So we have remainder, now balance remainder will be 2 square by 7, which is 4. This is one remainder. And this one, anyway it is 1. This is 0. This is 1. 2 power 20, we got it here. Remainder 4. And what about 3 power 20? 3 power 20 by 7 can be written as 3 power 3 whole power 6 into 3 square by 7, which is 9 by 7. Remainder will be 2. So for this also you got 2. Now if you add all the remainders, what and all we got is 2 plus 4 plus 1 plus 0 plus 1 plus 4 plus 2 divided by 7. 4 plus 2 6 is 7, and here also 7. So final remainder will be 0. That means this whole number, when divided by 7, we are getting remainder as 0. So make a note of it here, that number divided by 7, we are getting remainder 0. This is done. Now let us move to logic for 3. I'll write down here. Okay. For 3, 2 power 25 power 20 by 3. Now directly you can apply Euler's theorem. Or else 25 means it will be remainder 1 right here. 1 power 20 by 3. Anyway, remainder will be 1. Similarly for 26. Now 26 power 20 by 3. It will be easy if you take negative remainder, because 27 will give you remainder 0, but then you have only 26. That means you are in a deficit of 1. So your remainder is minus 1 whole power 20 by 3. Remainder will be 1 again. Similarly, 27, you will get remainder 0. 28, remainder will be 1. 29 power 20 by 3, remainder will be minus 1 whole power 20 by 3. Now remainder will be 1. So again, remainder you are getting 1. For 30, again 0, 31, 1. So finally, you are getting 1 plus 1, 2, 2 plus 1, 3, 4, 5. So you are getting 5 as remainder. 5 when divided by 3, final remainder will be 2. That means number when divided by 3, you are getting remainder as 2. Now you see, a number when divided by 7 remainder is 0. Next number will be 7. It can be next 14, next 21, next 28, and so on. Similarly, number when divided by 3 remainder 2 means it should be 2 or 5 or 8, 11, 14, 17, 30, sorry, 20, and so on. This is one series and this is one series. What is the first common number? 14 is the first common number. So ultimately, a final remainder when n is divided by 21 will be 14. We can get many other remainders, but always positive remainder will be the least. But negative remainders, there can be infinitive negative remainders. So this is all about a third question. Please do comment, especially for this question, if you are interested to know Chinese remainder theorem and Euler's theorem. Okay, let's move on to a fourth question. The question says, a farmer has 945 cows and 2475 sheep. Now, he says, he forms them into flocks, keeping cows and sheep separate. That means, let this be flock of cows. We don't know how many flocks are there for cows. And let this be flocks of sheep. Sheep are kept in these flocks. But again, here also, we don't know how many flocks of sheep are there. But then he is saying, having same number of animals in each flock. There are same number of animals in each flock. Even cow flock has same animals. Sheep flock also having same animals. That means height of each flock is same. This is one condition. And if these flocks are as large as possible, that means maximum number of animals should be kept in each flock. That means number of flocks will be minimum. Height will be maximum, so number of flocks will be minimum. So maximum number of animals in each flock. So what he is asking is, then find maximum number of animals in each flock and also total number of flocks. Maximum number of in each flock we can find if we are able to find the height of each flock. That means it is the maximum number of animals in each flock. Here the height is same for this one cows also, height is same for goats also. That means this height should divide this sheep and this cow equally. Means that should divide integrally, not equally. That height should divide cows and sheep integrally, only then no animal will be left behind when they are kept into groups. So now the height, let the height be h. Now the motto is h should divide 945 and 2475 integrally without any decimal. So suppose if you have numbers a, b, c, d, and if you want to find number n which divides a, b, c, d, leaving remainder 0, that means you are finding the HCF of a, b, c, d. Okay, and the two maximum number. Okay, so now HCF of 945 and 2475. The easier way to calculate find the HCF for this is, take out the common number in both of these. 5 is common in here and here. So if you take 5 common, 5 8s are 45, 9s are 45, 189, and here 5 4s are 20, 47, 5 9s are 5 5s are. So this will be the numbers. And again, 9 is common. 9 can be divide this and this. If I take 9 common, it will be 45 outside and it will be 21. And if I take 9 common, 5 is 45 and 5 is 45. Now you don't have anything common here. So your HCF is 45. That means height of each flock is 45. So maximum number of animals in each flock is 45. We got answer for this. And total number of flocks. The total number of flocks will be, total number of cow flocks will be 945 by 45, and total number of sheep flocks will be 247 by 45. So it will be 945 by 45. It will be 21 flocks of sheep, of cow, and 2475 by 45. We have 55 flocks of sheep. So total there will be 76 flocks. So our answers are 45 and 76. Coming to our fifth question, it's given that the given figure ABC, AB is 10,
AC is 6, AE is 4. Since this is right angle, this is also a right angle. And always check for this. If in a circle we are given the diameter, then always remember this diameter will always make 90 degrees on the circumference. So this will be 90. Always try to draw this kind of figure. So here you can make an extension from here to here. This gives you 90 degrees. Okay, so what we are essentially doing is we are finding the similarity. We have 90 degrees here, we have 90 degrees here. And also angles in the same segment will be equal. That is also a property of a circle. Suppose we have a segment here, angles in the same segment will be equal. Okay. Angles in the same. Suppose this is a minor arc, this is a major arc, and this is a minor sector, this is a major sector. Angles in the same sector are equal. So this angle and this angle are equal. So here we have alpha, here also we have alpha. Now triangle ABE is similar to triangle ACD. Okay, accordingly we will write the equation. Side opposite to this alpha in small triangle is 4 by side opposite to this alpha is 6. Now side opposite to this 90 degrees is 10 by side opposite to this 90 degrees is AD. So you get AD as Pfizer 30 by 2, which means 15. So since AD is 15, circumradius will be AD by 2, which is 7.5. So we are done with all of 5 questions. So tomorrow I will be making video on September 2nd challenger series. Thank you.